Welcome to Questions with Pastor Dave. Questions with Pastor Dave is a weekly YouTube broadcast from Westminster United Methodist Church in Herod, Ohio, where Pastor Dave Burkhart will answer viewers' submitted questions. And now for your questions.
Well, good evening. It's good to be with you again for Questions with Pastor Dave. And I'm fortunate enough to have with me Amber Rex, who is a pastor who actually used to be a parishioner here at this church. And I just couldn't be more proud of this young lady. She felt the call in her life, and a church opened up, and she was able to go and begin to pastor that church. Got licensed as a local pastor and is now doing course of study school. So, Amber, I'm going to let you go ahead and share a little bit about your churches, and then we'll have Keith give us a question, and we'll go from there.
Perfect. I am the pastor at Roundhead United Methodist and Mount Zion United Methodist. We are a two-point charge, and I have been there around 3 years, and things are going pretty good. So
you kind of got through all that COVID stuff,
right?
Things are beginning to get back to normal.
Yep,
that's pretty awesome.
Starting.
I will say it's been a blessing for me too. Got to serve with Amber on an Emmaus weekend here just a week ago, and man, we had a great time. And it was the first time we ever got to work together in ministry like that.
Right.
So
that was fun.
That was pretty exciting. I mean, as pastors, we work together in ministry as a pastor and parishioner, but definitely made it fun. Well, good evening. Back with me again is Pastor Amber Rex. Glad to have you here, Amber. It's always great to be able to do stuff with you. And so we're going to turn to Keith and let Keith bless us with another question.
Well, the question this evening is, should pastors just be paid a livable wage, or should their pay be directly linked to the amount of regular parishioners or donations received? Is there a responsibility to live within financial boundaries, or is it okay for pastors to live better than the average person in their congregation?
Well, that's a good question, and it's sort of a hard one for pastors to answer, but I'll tell you, the Bible is perfectly clear in the fact that a pastor is due his wages, and of course, at that time, they were all men, and we have women now, so him or her are due their wages, and the church should pay a livable wage. There's no doubt about that. I will say, though, one thing that I noticed when I became a Christian, even before I became a pastor, the things of this world didn't really mean as much to me. When I was younger, I used to work, but not only that, I always had side jobs going. I did a lot of construction work, built patio rooms for people and that kind of stuff. It seemed like I was always wanting to make a little more money here and a little more money there, and I was just never really satisfied with it. And there's something about becoming a Christian, the things of the world become less and less important, and it's more that you just want to care for what things you have and the things that you need. You know, we need cars. We have to get from point A to point B. It's not like, you know, I live 15 miles away. It'd be a long walk every day to come to the church.
It would.
So definitely a pastor should be paid a decent livable wage. And for the most part in the United Methodist Church, we are. The conference, we're on a like a tier level. We have a district that is over the individual churches, and then a conference that's over the districts. And they set our salaries every year. They don't set our salaries, but a minimum salary, mm-hmm. And it's a livable wage. So
it is.
So that's a good thing, and I believe that every pastor should be paid a livable wage. Now, the second part of the question goes into the fact that should pastors live better than their average parishioner, and that's a difficult question to answer. I know that my salary is just slightly below the average salary, I believe, And I'm perfectly satisfied with that. In fact, there have been years where I actually turned down raises that my churches wanted to give me because it would have put the church, not particularly here at Westminster, but another church that I was serving, it would have caused them some really, some financial stress. Mm-hmm. And to me, preaching the Word of God and being a vibrant church is more important than me making extra money.
Right.
Yeah, that's about where I stand on it.
For me, I think it comes down to, as well, I agree with you, but at the end of the day, it's between God and I how I spend my money. I should be tithing, and then I should be living how God wants me to live. You know, with that being said, maybe a little bit more modest. I'm not going to be building a multi-million dollar home anytime soon. But at the end of the day, it's between me and God. And I think that, for me, that's what it comes down to.
Yeah. And honestly, neither of us and probably none of our pastor friends really live an extravagant lifestyle as far as... nobody I know has a private jet or...
I do not. Not yet.
Lamborghini
no.
or any of those exotic cars.
But I don't think we're called to live like bums either.
Oh, certainly not. Certainly
so,
not.
So, I mean, everything in moderation. You know, I like some nice things. So, but in moderation.
Yeah. Yeah, as long as I got clothes on my back and a car that gets me from point A to point B, I'm good to go.
Yes.
So, but yeah, our churches, especially in this area, I think have been very generous with us. I left a factory job and when I got called into ministry and actually the church came up to about what I was making there. I did take a little bit of a pay cut, but oh my goodness, it's certainly been worth it to be able to share the Word of God and be able to minister to people. Well, you know, when you see people that you're able to help out, it's pretty neat.
Absolutely.
And I do believe that each church should have an expense account for a pastor. They should not have to take their own money to do church business work.
Mm-hmm.
But for the most part, I think that our churches do take pretty good care of us.
They do. And now I'm a little different than you. You're full-time. I'm part-time.
Correct.
So I still have another job. I'm considered bivocational. So I actually have two other jobs and then ministry. So
yeah.
My finances are any different, but my income isn't solely the church either.
Right.
So not that really... It doesn't change how I spend my money either.
Yeah, I actually did that for the first probably 3 or 4 years that I was in the ministry. I was part-time. The church that I served was actually a really good-sized building. I think it would seat about 120 people, and we had 8 people going there. And so, it was. If I was only at the church, it would have been some very lean times.
Yeah.
I think I got $50 a week to preach there on Sunday, but was working my regular job,
yeah.
and just didn't really have a lot of extra time to put into the church. And then when I was offered the full-time position, then of course my salary jumped considerably, so. But I tell you, one of the things that has become a real burden to a lot of pastors, especially those who are ordained, so. So what they have to do is they have to get a 4-year degree and then 3 years of seminary and then work their way through the ordination process.
Mm-hmm.
They're so deeply in debt by the time that they get to preaching from school debt and education that it's really difficult to get out of that. So, so there's another place where I believe the church needs to really step up and help with the financial responsibility of the education of the pastor.
Absolutely.
I know when I went through course of study, there were some grants through our district and through the conference that my churches had to pay very little as far as my educational expenses, which was really great.
Mm-hmm.
But Yeah, a lot of them that go the ordination route, they require a lot more finances coming in from the church, and because they've got a lot of debt to pay off. So, pastors deserve a fair and living wage. Do they need to be paid, six-figure salaries? No, I don't think so. Although I do know some that make that, and if the church is able to do that, and
absolutely. At the end of the day, we all have callings.
Mm-hmm.
Our calling is in the ministry, so we all need to make a living as well to live within those callings. So that's what it comes down to.
Yeah,
as well.
And in the secular world, if a businessman or someone skilled in business goes to take over a CEO position, he's going to make more than someone who's working on the line. And it works the same way in ministry, really. There's no way that I would be skilled enough to go and run one of the largest churches in our district because I just don't have that business mindset to be able to do that. And so does he deserve to make more money? Absolutely. There's no doubt about it. So
agreed.
Yeah. And so so should they be paid a living wage? No doubt. And no reason why the more educated, higher credentialed pastors shouldn't make a little bit more than those who are licensed locals like you and I. And we're just, like I say, we're just glad to be able to be in the ministry and sharing God's word with other people. So we're just going to keep doing that. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So it's good to have you with us. Great question. I would never fault a pastor unless they really flaunt what they've got and what they do, live way above their means. That's not good stewardship. We're going to tithe to our churches. We're going to practice the stewardship the best that we can. Pray that we can honor God and all of that. Well, again, it's been great to have you here with me, and we hope that maybe this gave you the little information about paying your pastor. And so we look forward to being back with you again with another question. Thank you.
He's right there to guide you, unseen or not.